Salutations everybody, it is Maddie here today with a Starfield discussion video. The community discussions continue onwards, this one coming from Zibrenin, who says, Starfield, science fiction Star Trek style versus science fantasy Star Wars style discussion. Which do you prefer and what it would look like? Now you already know my favorite game of all time is a Star Wars game, so anytime I get the chance to talk about a Bethesda Game Studios title and then fanboy about a Star Wars game in turn, you know I'm taking you up on that idea. So for those who don't know, my favorite game of all time is Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. I adore it so much as a role-playing game. It was just its 15th birthday, and it did so much for me to turn me into the gamer I am today. But as for Starfield, what path would it go along? For those who need some more examples, on the science fiction side, we have things like Mass Effect, Prey, Deus Ex, which are games that have that science you can buy into because the technology and universe surrounding it and being established ultimately makes it more believable. The player can buy in with ease. Where with science fantasy, you have more of those, all right, I'll bite moments. And in turn, the player's almost compensating at times because it's speculative fiction, which is still drawing upon certain things to make it ultimately a believable experience. Considering I've recently played and reviewed Prey Moon Crash, which once again, please do check out that review because it is such a superb DLC, but I do find myself learning I am more of a science fiction guy as time goes on. Granted, like I said, my favorite game of all time is a science fantasy title, but I find myself becoming further immersed in titles when I have the text right in front of me, the lore right in front of me, the environmental storytelling right there to flesh out whatever is happening, where it's not like this is happening and just buy into it and we'll tell you about it later. Science fiction manages to establish and successfully bring to life the universe it's trying to. Not that science fantasy cannot. A fine example of this is pretty much the midichlorians in Star Wars, where they're like, we're gonna explain the Force, and people are like, no, don't, just leave it as something that's kind of special and unknown. But I think science fantasy, in my opinion, when it comes to video games, lends it more so to the side of gameplay. Because for example, if in the character creator in Starfield, I could, for example, create a mech as my race, and that mech could specialize in some type of laser katana, you know what I'm saying? Like, that sounds so dope. And not that you can't blend the two, as in you can have some science fantasy fueled gameplay and then really establish your universe more along the lines of science fiction. But when I think of Starfield, admittedly, I think a little bit of how Destiny plays out, not in the gameplay structure where you're going on strikes and raids and all that. No, I'm talking more so along the lines of you have your standard first person shooting, you have a set of abilities, you can activate an ultimate ability, and that kind of changes up how your character plays. Now, I have not played Destiny 2 whatsoever, and it's been many years since I played the first Destiny. But I do remember a class where, for example, you were shooting your guns as per usual, you activate the ultimate ability, you take out a crazy knife, and just eviscerate your opponents. Actually, it was a subclass. It was the Blade Dancer, I believe. And so thinking of something like that in Starfield, where you could have this big transformation in the gameplay, because they did confirm that there was going to be a new animation system in place, and with that, I expect there to be not only changes to the dialogue wheel, facial animations, I imagine that's going to be a big focus, but I also want to see the combat animations improve, and Bethesda Game Studios really go in on some type of unique combat system. Because we know they can do shooting well. Fallout 4, if anything, was a good shooter. I'd like to see them expand upon that, leave the good shooting as is, and then take it a step further with some unique melee combat that I think could ultimately impact Elder Scrolls 6, which is going to have a ton of melee combat. This whole conversation started with me going science fantasy, then gameplay. But when I talk about the story, the universe, the world, which is ultimately Bethesda Game Studios' bread and butter, I see them going more along the lines of science fiction for the reasons I stated previously about being able to maybe twisting a reality of our own ever so slightly to make something believable. Now, this is just the speculatus deeply ingrained in my soul, but I have this odd optimism for Starfield compared to any other BGS title that's been announced. And I think a part of that is because it's the unknown, and it's got to be exciting to finally break away from ES and Fallout and just say, we're doing something brand new for the first time in many years. That has me pretty jazzed, and I can't wait to see more on it. But for now, these are just some ideas based off the science fantasy versus fiction. I'm going to lean more towards the science fiction side of things personally, as I don't really think many people can do science fantasy better than Star Wars. I'm sorry, that is just my opinion there. I love Star Wars to death, and I don't think Bethesda Game Studios will ever create a better science fantasy game than Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. Can it still be good though? Yes, but I think based off the type of creators they are, science fiction's their way to go. Plus, when you look at the catalog of science fiction games I presented, each of them all rely on the same pillars to create their universe. Furthermore, it didn't stop them from creating intuitive, thought-provoking gameplay systems like Prey and the Glue Gun. So those are just my thoughts on it. Thank you, Brennan, for the excellent discussion topic, and I'd love to hear your thoughts on this topic in the comments down below, so do fire away. Other than that, follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook, those links are in the description down below, along with my Patreon. Do consider supporting that, as it fuels all the content we create here. Stay sexy, stay active, I love you all. Peace.